called Fiddler. Yeah. And we had trouble tying uptown for the show. We opened in Detroit at the Fisher Theater, which seats 3,000 people. And I had a song in the first act, and the wonderful Bert Convy had a song at the top of the second act. And the song I had was called Now I Have Everything. And Bert, the first performances at the Fisher Theater in Detroit, which seats 3,000 people, Bert had a song which is effortlessly the low point of the Harnick and Bock collaboration. And so Bert would deliver that song, and there would be no applause. None whatsoever. Bert became concerned about this. He said, Bert Convy, a wonderful actor, a wonderful singer, a wonderful. So then they thought, well, why don't they take my song called Now I Have Everything? And then Bert will sing it with a different lyric, a different orchestration, a different rhythm at the top of the second act. So Bert, of course, he delivered wonderfully on that. He got a huge applause. Marred only by the fact that a woman was heard just as the applause subsided, a woman saying to her husband, hey, Morris, didn't the little tailor sing that in the first act? So Bert was very desperate. So on the flight from Detroit to Washington, Bert pleaded with Sheldon Harnick to write another song, which is this one. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a tailor by the hand, turned him around, and miracle of miracles, won him to the promised land. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God would frown, but like he did so long ago in Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. When Moses softened Pharaoh's heart, that was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man today. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a tailor by the hand, turned him around, and miracle of miracles led him to the promised land. When David slew Goliath, yes, that was a miracle. That, when God gave us manna in the wilderness, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, the most miraculous is the one I thought could never be. God has given.